that I think works really well. The reason why I started doing this was to really, A, defend the chop, and also if I do get chopped, I'm in good position where I'm not going to go to my belly. Okay? I think that's something that was really important to me. I don't want to be on my belly. Okay? Whenever I'm on my body, second worst position in wrestling. Okay? So, guy comes up, doesn't matter which side you get on. Alright? So, guy gets on. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys an outside stand up. So, what that means is I'm stepping up with my outside leg, my free leg. Okay? And I'm pulling that chop arm away from him. So when I stand up outside leg, and I bring that inside arm away. Alright, see what I do? I don't like coming inside like this, because all he has to do is continue to chop me, and there I go. I have no post to keep me from going to my belly. So again, off the whistle, outside step, okay? Inside arm goes away, here. Look at the angle I create, okay? I'm actually stepping up to the side because I want to put as much distance between the chop arm and his chop hand. All right, if I keep this here, again, he's strong. If I'm far away, he's not strong. He's not going to be able to pull me back down. So again, when I step up, stepping up straight in front, because he can look how deep he is. So chop, I'm gonna be in trouble. Now, once I step up and I pull that arm away, my other free hand, okay, that's attacking his chop hand. So off the whistle, stepping up outside leg, pulling inside arm away, here. Grab it. Attack it. From here, his first instinct is to try to make up some ground, but he pushed in me, gonna push in. Right up to my feet. Attacking two hands. Right? Two hands. I have a terrible grip. I have little baby hands. So I need to get two hands on this. Here. Then I get it to my hip. Here. Right to wrestle. When I cut, right? And this is just a little thing. Right? Some little things that can set the tone in your matches. When I cut and I get back down my wrestling mat, zero seconds where he is safe, all right? Where he can have a break, where there'll be no physical activity done, all right? If I go here, now he's like, okay, reset. All right, now let's go. Again, it's a mentality. Here, right into it. No space, no time for him to take any breaks. So again, outside step, inside arm away, free hand, attacking, okay? Here, he's gonna pull me up, step onto my feet, start walking my feet out. Walk my feet out, back pressure. Hand in the back pocket, come in, right to collar tie. All right, nice and low. Now, I wanna also show you guys if he does chop you, all right? Guy really has a good chop. So when I step up here, he chop. The reason why I have this so out far in front is that when he does chop me, my hands stay out in front of me. They don't get pulled in to my body. From here, I'm done. I'm going to my belly. I don't care how tough you are, how good you are. You're gonna be going down your belly. So again, I'm here, he chops. Now, I'm gonna do a changeover. I'm changing him over from my right side, putting him on my left. I'm going to drop my knee down. I'm going to throw my elbow right in his side. All right, go ahead and hang on me. Go ahead, hang. Here. All right, I'm pulling my knee through. I'm in sort of a short stand situation or even a short sit. My butt's on my heel, elbow to my side. Back and straight. Now, if this guy, he can't take me this way because my post. There's no way. If he takes me over to the side, I post and come up. If he starts to drive into me, right up to my feet. Out, right to wrestle. One last time. And he chops. So here, chops. Hands out in front. Knee exchange, okay? Knee down, rotate other leg up, elbow to the side. Okay? Here. right to wrestle. Questions? Let's try it. Ready?